So now we're ready to start chapter 5, and in chapter 5 we are going to be doing probability, but we're going to be dealing strictly with what are called probability distributions, or specifically discrete probability distributions. This is going to be different than what we did in chapter 4, where we were just trying to find classical and empirical probabilities. And the three topics that we're going to see here, we're going to see what is a probability distribution. Then we're going to learn how to find the mean, variance, standard deviation, and expectation of a probability distribution. And then we're going to look at the binomial distribution. And then on this video, of course, we're just going to do the first one here. We're just going to look at probability distributions. So with probability distributions, we need to know these terms. A random variable is a variable whose values are determined by chance. So a random variable would be like throwing a die or flipping a coin, drawing a name out of a hat, something that's random. We discussed the definition of random in chapter 1. And then a discrete probability distribution consists of the values of the random variable can assume and then the probability of each. So for instance, when you flip a coin, you could get a head or a tail, and the probabilities would be one half chance head, one half chance tail, or 50% heads, 50% tails. If you were talking about a dice, you would, or a die, a single die, you would have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then each of those would have a 1/6 chance. If you add up all the probabilities of all the events, it should add up to 1, because that's everything that can happen and all their probabilities. And then each probability within there has to be between 0 and 1 because it's a probability, and we discussed that 0 means it can't happen and 1 means it has to happen. And so all the probabilities within that probability distribution have to be between 0 and 1. So let's look at what they look like. So on this one, this is our die, and it says we're supposed to construct a probability distribution for rolling a single die, but then it just has it here. So, you know, how did they construct it? So how they constructed it is they said to themselves, well, what are the things that could happen on a die? Well, when you roll a single die, you could either get a 1 or a 2 or a 3 or a 4 or a 5 or a 6. So they list those along the top. These are the things that could happen when you roll a regular single six-sided die. Okay, so they start with that along the top. And then underneath each of these, we're going to say what is the probability of that happening. So this 1/6 right here means that when you roll a die, you have 1/6 chance of getting a 1. So that's what that 1/6 means. And then all of these are the same. Because a die has 6 equal sides, and it has a different number on each side, then each side has a 1/6 chance of happening. And if we added those all up, these have to total to be 1. If they don't total to be 1, it's not a probability distribution. You've missed something. You've either, if it goes over 1, it means you have too much. If it's not, doesn't add up to 1, it means that you are missing something. Another thing, remember that these have to be between 0 and 1. So these can't be negative. Okay, so these numbers underneath here, these probabilities, have to be between 0 and 1. Let me make a little thing here. So all of these P of X's have to be between 0 and 1. And when we add them all up, they have to equal 1. So on this next one, it says we're supposed to represent graphically the probability distribution for the sample space for tossing 3 coins. So I'm going to go back here and I'm going to show how we are going to construct that first. So the sample space for tossing 3 coins, and what they're going to mark is the number of heads that you have when you do that. So let's go back. I'll just use this kind of as a blank screen here. When you roll When you flip a coin or flip three different coins, there's different things that could happen. It's kind of similar to the boys and girls when you talk about three boys and, or three children in a family. So you could have tails, 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 heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, tails, tails. So those are all the ways to have two tails. And then we could have two heads with one tail. And then we could have all heads. So the way that they're doing it on this is they're showing for the top, what are the possible things that could happen for the number of heads. So X is number of heads. Okay. So I could either have no heads up here when I have three tails that has no heads. And then these three have one head. So this one has no heads. These ones have one head. These ones have two heads. Heads, heads, tail, heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, heads. So that's another outcome. And then here you have three heads. Again, you can set this distribution up differently. You could talk about how many tails there were instead of how many heads. You could talk about what you actually got. So the tails, 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 heads, and so on. But the way they decided to do it was to count how many heads you had as your top here. So with that said, what's the probability? And these are your X's. So what's the probability of each of those X's happening? Okay, so these are your X's. So the probability of getting no heads, well, there's only one way. Let me use a different color here. So there's only one way that you can get no heads, and that's to get tails, tails, tails. Remember, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different things here. So you have a 1 in 8 chance that you're going to get three tails, in other words, no heads. What's the probability that you're going to get one head? Well, there's three different ways to do that. There's three different ways to get just one head out of the 8. And so we say for 1, we have a 3/8 chance. Same thing with two heads, 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 tails, heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, heads. There's three ways out of the 8 where you end up with two heads. And then there's only one way that you end up with three heads. So 1/8. And so that's where they came up with this table here. That's theirs looks a little prettier than mine, but here's our no heads, one head, two heads, three heads, 1/8 chance of getting no heads, 3/8 chance of getting either one head or two heads, and then a 1/8 chance of getting all three heads. And then here, they've just, I apologize if you can hear that, my phone keeps going off. They've made a probability distribution graphically from this. So they've represented, it isn't really a histogram, because remember, a histogram, you have your bins that would go from one value to another value. So this isn't really a histogram, but it's kind of like a histogram. But we only have one thing in our bin. This is just the zeros. So you have a 1/8 chance of getting 0. This is a 3/8 chance of getting 1, a 3/8 chance of getting a 2, and then again a 1/8 chance. So it just kind of shows how the distribution is least likely on the ends and more likely to have one head or two one head or two heads. And that's really it for section 5.1. The big keys there are as far as like how to set up these probability distributions. And it's just a matter of figuring out all the things that could happen and the probability of each. And then the other thing is what I mentioned back here. They're going to ask you in your homework, could this be a probability distribution? And you're going to look at these numbers down here. Doesn't really matter what could be what's up on top, because there could be any number of things that could be an outcome. But what you want is these numbers on the bottom need to total 1, and none of them can be negative or over 1. You know, so if they gave you one where, say it said, I don't know, it could be red, blue, yellow. But then for the probabilities, for red, they said the probability was negative 0.25. Well, that's not possible. You can't have a probability of negative 0.25. And then let's say that wasn't an issue. They didn't have any negatives. But let's say they said this was a 1/5 chance, this was a 2/5 chance, and this was a 1/5 chance. Well, 1/5 plus 2/5 plus 1/5 only equals 4/5. So this cannot be a probability distribution. They've either miscounted something or they've missed an option. Like, was there another color, or was maybe the red or the yellow or something 2/5 instead of 1/5? But these should all total up to be 5/5 or 1. So when they're asking you those questions, that's what you're looking for. And that's it for 5-1. Good luck on your homework, and have a great weekend.